There is no doubt that reducing my carb intake has made a world of difference in how I feel, and a low-carb diet is a very effective weight loss strategy. But if you're just getting started on a low-carb diet, there are some things to consider. In this video, I will share 5 things that are good to know before you go low-carb. Number 1, eating too little fat will leave you feeling hungry. The foods you eat provide your body with calories that it uses for energy. That energy is derived mainly from carbs and fat. When you cut carbs, you rob your body of a primary energy source. If you also eat low fat, you cut out both energy sources and your body will turn on hunger and cravings to coax you to eat more food. Remember that the goal of a low-carb diet is to turn your body into a better fat burner. But to get to that point, you need to feed your system fat. Even if you eat enough fat, there will likely be a period of time right after cutting carbs when you feel low on energy and generally worse rather than better. This transition period is due to the fact that your body has not yet developed all of the enzymes and processes it needs to rely on fat as its primary fuel source. To work through this transition, one of the things your body needs is simply time. Another thing it needs is electrolytes. Electrolytes partner with water. When you cut carbs, your body releases a lot of water from glycogen stores in your muscles and liver. That water flushes out of your body and carries electrolytes along with it. If you don't replenish those electrolytes, which are things like magnesium, potassium, and salt, you will likely be prone to having muscle cramps, fatigue, and cravings. The easiest way to stay on top of this is to use an electrolyte supplement each day. In my home, we use Endure Electrolyte Supplement, which is available on Amazon, and I will link to it in the description area below if you are interested. Another thing to realize is that sugar is everywhere. Sugar is a carbohydrate. In fact, it is the most refined form of carbohydrate that you can consume. When you cut carbs, you will find that your success improves if you become somewhat of an ingredient detective. My rule for sugar is that it should not be one of the top 3 ingredients. So get in the habit of reading ingredient lists on packaged foods. And keep in mind that sugar goes by many aliases. Some common alternative names for sugar are corn syrup, dextrose, maltodextrin, fruit juice concentrate, and sucrose. So you need to be careful that you don't get fooled by creative marketing. For instance, this package of Golden Delicious Apple Crisps contains apples and oil, followed by corn syrup, sugar, and dextrose. Those are 3 added sugars, so in my book, this is not a good alternative for potato chips. The next consideration is medication. Medications for blood sugar regulation may need to be adjusted within a day of moving from a high-carb to a low-carb diet. There are other medications as well, including blood sugar meds, that can be affected by changes in your diet. So the takeaway is, if you are on a medication, don't start a low-carb diet without letting your doctor know about your intentions. And lastly, when it comes to low-carb dieting, age doesn't matter. Perhaps because I am in my 50s myself, a large portion of my audience is 50 years of age or older. Low-carb diets work for weight loss regardless of age. Many members of my coaching program have fully embraced the low-carb lifestyle and have found weight loss to be much easier than diets that they have tried in the past, despite having to deal with factors that come with age, like menopause for women and lower testosterone for men. And as an added bonus, issues like energy and mood improve and joint pain diminishes. So we can learn new tricks, or at least a new way of eating, as we age. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this was beneficial. If you'd like a guide to get started on a low-carb diet, I encourage you to follow the links in this video to learn more about my program. Please subscribe, and I will see you in next week's video. Till then, have a great week.